Hello everyone, this is Cipher Deck, and we are back in No Man's Sky. So today, we're going to leave this star system. But before we do, I'm going to name my planet, name the star system that we're in, and hopefully one day in the future, maybe a year from now, depending on how long it takes us to get to the center of the universe, we will come back here and we will know that this planet was the first place that gave us the raw materials to be able to buy our first bigger ship than this one, or what allowed us to build or buy a better ship. So let's go ahead and escape. Let's go ahead and go in here. This is the planet we were on. I'm going to go ahead and press X to rename it. And I'm going to name it Emerald, or E-M, A-U. E-A-M-U? E-A, or E-M-A-U. Because E-M is Emerald, or Emerald. AU is gold. You know what? I'm just gonna name it Emerald. Because why not? And then we'll do one. Because maybe we'll find another planet that has other things on it. But let's go ahead and name that. And we got a few thousand units for that. And then we'll get 5,000 units for naming this system. Now, I want to be able to find my systems that I started, and I want to number them so that every system that we go to will be named after the same thing with a different number. So let's go ahead and go here, and I'm going to name it, let's say Dexitron-1. Dexitron-1, and then this is the first planet. I don't know why Dexitron, but it sounds cool. And there we go. And now we have 8,000 units. So we are moving up in the chain. And we got so many things. Look at this. We're 30% complete. These, by the way, are rare animals and rare fauna, I believe, or rare fauna and rare floral, these things. So I'm guessing, because okay, so let's see, this is a unicarilari. This is a this was the last one I found. This was Riflucio. This is over here. This is the bottom right check mark. So it is rare animals. Let's see. That is the rare. It's another rare animal. This is the Uniclar. Yeah, there's that. So they're animals. These are rare animals. These are normal animals, apparently. Because this is a larger, similar version of this without the long ears. See that? So anyway, we'd have to spend a lot of time on a planet. I would like to do that. I probably will do a separate playthrough, but this is going to be more of a playthrough of getting to the center of the universe in a timely manner that hopefully won't take us, I don't know, a year to do it. I did a scan, and there's this, not the two planets that look obscene. Actually, there's a third planet even there, but there is a space station between them. It looks wrong. It looks wrong, but I think whenever I was coming into space, it said press A and D, and this is the pulse engine. Wow. That just looks so wrong, guys. But I guess it just depends on how you take it. right? it also looked weird from the planet that we were on, so I guess I just have a dirty mind. Probably do. Kind of want to stop on the planets before we leave the star system just to see what they look like. And they're far away. Look at this. It's taking 31 seconds, but if we were to slow down, it takes 7 minutes. And then whenever we started, it would have taken hours to get there. And then if we look here, this would take 3 minutes. But if we go into this mode, it'll take 16 seconds. So I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna go onto this planet, and then I'll take off and go over to where. Actually, let's do this. Whoa! Okay, let's go ahead and go down. Is that water? Whoa, we're burning up as we're coming into the atmosphere. That is amazing. It looks... Oh, what is that black? Is that us blacking out? Look at that gold. Toxic smoldering, regular, undetected flora. Limited fauna. Look at that gold! That is... Holy cow! Can I... Let's burn a hole into it. Let's make a bird's nest. Kind of thing. Here we go. Do that. Then we'll clean up the little edges. Okay. Alright. Not very much of a running start here. Actually, not a running start at all. Oh boy. Okay, here we go. Do not fall. Go, 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 go. I'm in, guys. Look at this. Okay. I know gold is one of those things that we're not really looking for. But how can you put the whole... Look, alright, let's go straight down. Okay, it's actually hitting that black stuff. The black rocks that it's... So we'll just do this, back and forth. Back and forth. Okay, let those black rocks go away. We have look at this thing. This thing is massive. Okay, have we found the ground? This is the ground. Look at how big this thing is. How much gold did we get out of that? Almost a stack. We're at 36,000. Let's move this over. Don't need that on us. Really don't need that on us either. Wow. Okay, so gold. It's worth having a stack or two. Look at how thick the freaking walls are. Just to get out of it. Just to get out of it. Okay, that's one side. Okay, that actually got out this way. Wow. Massive. Okay, the one thing about this planet, though, that I'm not liking... Actually, was it this side? Wait a minute. Oh, come on. Go away, green. Okay, this side, I think. This side was the one that... Okay. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Probably shouldn't mess with that. Oh jeez. Okay. I have no clue how close we are to the top. Okay. The longer it takes to get there is the scarier. We're only getting 2 gold per shot, by the way. If you're wondering. Oh, no. Okay. Now, where's my ship? It's over here. Let's go ahead and just shoot out the side here. Okay. Oh, no! Come on, last. I don't care if I would have hit here. Look at how massive that is, guys. That is absolutely crazy. Anyway, we got the gold. Is that gold too? It has a different shape to it. Let's check it. By the way, I could be... That's gold. Okay. Let's just scan some things here real quick. Alright. Those things have really cool wings. Those things... so cool that I want to kill one. No. Okay, this is, I'm gonna name this Goldilocks. Yep. Goldilocks. One. Actually, let's just do some weird symbols. just took it. Anyway, Goldilocks. This is what this planet is. Let's go ahead and take off. We're gonna go ahead and go back into space and trying to look for that space station where it was. So we'll go ahead and just leave. Okay, we're now in space. Okay, there's Emerald One. That's where we came from. This Goldilocks. And there's a planet. There's the actual space station, though. See, it's 1 hour away. But if we do this, it's only 9 seconds. Whoa! It's a pyramid. Yeah, it's a pyramid. It's a moon. That's a moon, by the way. It actually said it was a moon of this. I wonder if our planet had a moon. Man. Just the art on the space station... looks amazing. Okay, I am not controlling it now. Are those ships coming in too? Yes, they are. That looks like a cargo ship. So is that, let's see. Okay, it said that you could buy ships. I don't want to buy the pink one. Nothing against the pink one. I don't want to buy the pink one. Let's see, what's this one? Whoa! Flagbearer Gripen Qua. Make an offer on the lifeform ship. This has 21 slots. It's 838,000 units. It's not impossible. You can see that the weapons are advanced versus mine. Has better shielding. Yeah. Craziness. Just think, at some point, we will either have a ship or we will have bought a ship that has this going all the way around, and this going all the way around, and this going all the way around, and this going all the way around. Just think about that. That is our future. Wonder what the maximum amount of slots you can actually have in a ship is. I doubt it's confined by this box. I think the box is actually to make it look nice. Though they could have made it less OCD unfriendly by actually putting these all in just a straight line. I don't understand why you have to do this. Ugh. Anyway, of course we're going to decline. We don't have that money. Though we do have stuff to sell, and there's another pink one. Look at that. Look at that ship. Look at that ship. Oh my goodness, look at that ship. Your ship looks nice. I nothing against you. But look at this thing. Whoa. It has a big nostril nose hammer looking thing. He looks rhino-ish. Make an offer on his light. Okay. 19 slots. Looks like more of a fighting ship than anything else. Note, though, if we buy a ship, we have to have enough fuel for the launcher and the pulse engine to be able to use it. But this shape, this design, looks really cool. And the front, that is a really cool look as well. But anyway, thank you. These ships are definitely out of our price range. Another ship coming in. Oh my goodness. Okay, I know I keep looking at ships I can't afford, but look at this thing. Okay, he has no big upper lip apparatus. 31 slots. 5,354,000. I can see it, but he has no shield upgrades, only weapon upgrades. So yeah, wow. Okay, we're just seeing our future. We're seeing our future here. Let's go ahead and go up here. Okay, there's a guy in here also. Look at that. That is so cool. Flagbearer Gumyi. Viking standing neutral. The warrior's nostrils flare as I approach. It inhales deeply and barks out what could be a warning. I hurriedly mime that I am not with something. I don't know why I exited. Okay. I hurriedly mime that I am peaceful and no little of its kind or language. It takes a second to think, then suddenly grabs my multi-tool while barking again into my visor, streaking it with saliva. It's pointing at the indicator that shows which elements I carry. I do my best to keep calm. Isotopes carbon. We got that. The wearer gives me technology blueprint. A phase beam. Spacecraft laser device. We already have that, but that's cool. If we find a ship that doesn't have it, then boom. We also got our standing increased with the Viking. Nice. Okay, anything else? What is that? Multi-tool tech. Beam focus sigma. Faster mining beam processes on resource-rich materials. Definitely gonna take that. I'm probably gonna definitely install that too. This is an Outpost 9 Galactic Trade Terminal. Oh, nice! This is what we're looking for. On floor exploration, 3,000. Oh, this is actually telling me my information. User Cipher Deck stats, 3,243 units, static, alien colonists. Encountered 1, lonesome, aw, words collected 1, incomprehensible, most units accrued 10,000, insolvent, and ships destroyed, not gonna do that, sentinels destroyed, we might do that, extreme survival, hopeful, Space exploration, stargazer. We haven't made any exploration situations. Planet zoology scanned. I scan stuff. All kinds of stuff. Anyway, let's go ahead and sell stuff. Alright, so gold and emerald are not worth much in this colony. Or in this location. So we might want to take this to the next star system to sell it, because it is ample here, is what I'm thinking. Okay, carbon isn't selling for much. Plutonium, we can replace plutonium with thamium-9, so I'm going to go ahead and sell it. Then we can also check our starship inventory. We have 2 Geknip, right? Or this is Geknip, and that is Gek Charm. Geknip sells for positive here, so I'll go ahead and sell that. It sells for negative here, so I'm going to keep that. Iron Thamium 9, 530. We can also. Thamium 9 is such a great resource that we could use it to make money as well. We're already at 38,000 and we've barely even scratched the surface. We have enough emerald to get us into the hundreds of thousands. So that is good information that we can take to, yeah. So anyway, that's everything. I don't think I'm gonna buy anything here unless I absolutely have to. Let's check this door. 1 Atlas Pass version 3 required. How do I get an Atlas Pass? Atlas, you are my guidance. Tell me how I get an Atlas Pass, please. Nothing? Nothing? Okay, then. Look at that craziness. There's just... These ships are making me go crazy. So anyway, let's go ahead and get in. We'll go ahead and go to the next star system. And we're gonna go ahead and press M. All right, so first off, you need to know that every star that you see in this galaxy that's on my screen right now, 90% of them are visitable. And let's see, deselect that, and we'll see that all these stars, even the small ones, all of those are all visible. The very tiny ones, like here, those aren't, but like that is, and even over here, and on the bottom, all over, every direction you look is the star system, and you are able to go to any of them. So, gonna go ahead and press backspace. It says, this is Dexatron 1, this is where we started. And it says that to the distance to the center is 174,169.8 light years to the center of the universe. That's nuts. Okay, let's go ahead and get out of this and go back into it. Okay. And then we actually have this line now that shows us where we need to go. This is Atlas showing us our path. Okay, this is the next location we need to go to. This is 48.4 light years away. This is barely even touching the distance for which we need to travel. And if I was to travel every video that we do, we would still be doing this for probably a month. Even if I did 2 videos a day, it still would probably be a few months before we ever got to the center of the universe. And we would have missed all the fauna and all the plants that we would have been able to explore. So I'm going to go ahead and engage. And here we go. Wow. And we ended up right next to another space station. And this is a completely different galaxy. So let's land here and see what the prices are here. Wow. This is crazy. I'm glad we are next. Whoa. Something just came in behind me and made it like collision noises. I can't see it now, but wow. How far out there can I run? I'm not gonna do it. It would probably take forever to get to the end of that. Let's see. And Atlas Pass version 1. We need to figure out what this Atlas Pass situation is. I love the noises, just the walking, everything. Okay. Whoa. It looks different. Let's check the trade prices. Okay. Where it's collected. Space exploration, stargazer still. Thanks. Okay, let's go ahead and sell. Emerald. Positive here. Look at that. 173,000. That's 281 per. Let's go ahead and get rid of that. I'm gonna go ahead and sell this too. That's 43,000. Just money, guys. Money. Oh my goodness. Hello, sir. You look crazy. Your mouth is interloper. He used the word interloper. The warrior looks at me with fire in its eyes. The species is clearly aggressive, and I doubt I'm welcome yet. The life form bows in greeting. Tradition and honor perhaps dictated. I don't feel in imminent danger, and am about to turn and leave when the creature points towards my multi-tool. It barks with concern and makes a motion to suggest that I should hand it over. Okay. If I hand it over, he may give me something better. If I don't hand it over, then I am not handing it over. I think I'm gonna hand it over. I'm gonna trust him. His young boyish like face. I'm gonna trust him, and hopefully he'll give me something good. The warrior nods in satisfaction. It offers me an improved version. Oh my goodness. That is 8 slots. I think that is far more than what I currently have. It also looks absolutely cool. Wow. So the only thing it is missing is the visor, which we can probably add back on, and we'd still have 4 slots available. Plus the fact that we have an upgraded scanner detection range increase. And then 4 slots for upgrades, guys. 4 slots for upgrades? Yes, I am going to accept it. I will accept it. And the Viking has increased. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Wow. Okay. Let's take a look at this thing. Let's see if we can go ahead and add the visor. We can. There we go. The visor's installed. That was very hard. All right. We have 2 upgrades that we can use. We need titanium and plutonium. And we need plutonium for that one. So it looks like we're going to need to farm some plutonium and more massive ships. Look at the little things like that. That little angle piece right there. Look at that. Has a weird side thruster thing rotated. I guess that rotates for him. That's so weird. Weird. A ship design. This one isn't. This looks crazy awesome. 2 aliens, but I guess it doesn't count the aliens that I meet at their ships. Okay, it looks like this is the version of Viking species that's in this area. So let's make an offer on the life form ship. 25 slots is about 2 million. So maybe we need to look at getting around 2 million before we think about shopping around for a ship, because it seems like 1 to 5 million is where the 25 plus slots are going to be at. Really would like to have the 5 million. Wow, that's big. Look how big those. Okay, let's check this one. It's like, I like carrying lots of things in my wings. Let's see. Yeah, that's a 30 slot. That's 4 million. So I think that's our goal. 4 to 5 million is our goal. Let's go ahead and get in. And we need to land and get some plutonium so we can upgrade our gun. We should also probably scan the universe incoming. Signal. Okay, the incoming signal is coming from this massive planet. I'm going to probably come in. Oh yeah, we need to test the rocks. That's iron. That's damium 9. Okay, so we definitely need to get thallium 9 before we go down, because it's going to be our primary resource for our suits and our gun and all of that. So we want to make sure that we have a good stack of it. It's a good stack of 500. Actually, we have a stack, don't we? Or we've been using it. Yeah, wow, we emptied out this. This was filled with stuff. So yeah, let's go ahead and get these taken care of, and then once we come back out of the atmosphere of this planet, we'll be able to go ahead and get more of it if we need it. Okay, let's go ahead and go down. Okay, I'm glad that it had me come in a little light, or a little early, so I could scan the ground for light forms and things. Actually, there's something right here. Okay. Oh, we know we need a chip for that, right? Don't we need some kind of... Yeah, bypass chip. Do we even have the resources? We've been selling everything. Oh, keep looking at the wrong thing. Alright, so... bypass chip. We need to move the iron over. Then we need to E. It's not only iron. It is plutonium. Plutonium! You dog! Anyway, sometimes the little canisters? Do we have any little canisters? Gek charm. Nothing found. Do we have any of the little canisters around here? A lot of times those have. Okay, we have, looks like plutonium right over here, or at least an isotope. Whoa! New gun, buddy. Okay, let's go ahead and get this. We need plutonium now for all kinds of things, now that I decided I wasn't going to use it anymore. Let's see. We need to upgrade this. This requires plutonium, but we need titanium. This requires iridium, but I sold it. I think. Did I sell the iridium? Oh, no. Iridium is just not too far from the ship. Okay. Where's the ship? Let's go to the ship. Azaratori Desert. Okay, now. Iridium. Transfer that over. And we can go ahead and focus beam sigma. I wonder if I can fight these guys now. Let's shoot them. Hostiles approaching. Okay, probably not a good idea. Oh, it dropped something. Oh, and titanium. Come on. Oh, jeez. Ouch. Let's see what these are. Neutrino module. Sentinel Forest deactivated. Grenade intensity Sigma. So I guess I would have to have a grenade on my weapon to be able to use that. Let's see. We can actually add this now because we need titanium. Woo! Now we need to also make one of those chips. Please be another reload accelerant Sigma for the bolt caster. Okay, I don't have the bolt caster. Kind of trying to make the gun mostly a mining gun, since we're going to be doing mining things mostly. I accomplished a milestone. One sentinel destroyed. So that is a milestone that I should be doing. Okay. What was I looking for here? Okay, I could actually put the bolt caster on it. Can I even put this on there? Reload. Okay. Need to make a... No, E. Okay, there we go. Signal scanner online. Planetary location beacons are responding. So we can give to a monolith, which sounds really cool. Colonial outpost. Transmission. I guess we could listen to a transmission, or we could go to a shelter. What'd I choose? Oh, I didn't. Okay, good. No! I have to make another one? That makes no sense. And, of course, I don't have the plutonium to do it. Oh, okay, good. Oh, what? That's our gun. Alright, so... Don't back out of these. If you don't want to waste materials. Oh, boy. Okay, let's go back in there. Now it's... Okay, yeah, now it's popping up like as if I hadn't used it before. I think we're going to go with the monolith. Searching for ancient alien artifacts. A monolith. 5 minutes away. Alright. Got all this stuff. Checked out the inside of that. Let's go ahead and head to the monolith. Oh, life support power is very low. Let's use our thallium. That's the purpose of it. And lift off. You know what I just remembered? Our ship requires plutonium. Alright, let's see if we can find... Whoa, wait a minute. Is it right just... That wasn't very far. Look at that. I'll let me land wherever it will allow me to land. Come on. Oh, make it. That is a monolith. what is this? Oh, a knowledge stone. I've learned the Viking word for visual. I'll use that in a minute. Let's get these. Use the Viking word for detection. Learn the Viking word for warp. I started saying it early because I figured it would teach me Viking and not something else. Alright. So, let's see what this says. I place my palm on the monolith, then stand back when it melts in response to my touch. Molten rocks drip down the stone, exposing a hollow interior. Inside, I see riches that are beyond belief, ancient technologies and cargo that would aid my journey. Lava continues to drop, and the edifice seems unstable, but equipment that could aid me is within arm's reach. Suddenly, the voice of an ancient tribe shakes the ground I stand on. Okay. I would think that this is a test. Why would it want me to reach in? If I reach in, would I get something? And if I did, would it really aid me? Or if I stand back and let it do what it's going to do, maybe whatever ritual or whatever thing it is doing will actually help me. So I think I'm going to go ahead and stand back. The ancient warriors who once worshipped here bless my show of respect. Health at maximum. Standing with the Viking increased. Learn the word awake. Viking effigy is what I received. I've learned 5 words. I'm a babbler. So that is cool. By deciding, making the right choices, you will get rewards. And by making the wrong choices, we will get either no reward or our standing will become bad. Which that sounds like what it would have happened, is our standing would have become bad because of us trying to reach in. Now, we, because of that, have gotten a Viking effigy, which is worth 25,000 units. We have also, through learning that of respect and being honorable, listening to what they're saying, we've also gotten this gun. So, we're learning as we go by being respectful to those who came before us on this planet. Let's do a scan. I need plutonium. You see what I see? You see what I see? Ouch. I wonder if it's going to be the same thing that was on my Emerald Planet. Oops, how do I change this? Trolls. Let's see. Melee is Q. Interact. Activate torch. Increase zoom is mouse 2. K. Jump show silent fire. Fire grenade is mouse 3. Reload is R. Change weapon mode is X. Okay. Let's go see what's in here that has the symbol that we love and like and want more of. Is that emerald? Oh, you are my friend. Emerald, you are my friend. Oh my goodness, guys. All right, what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and end the video here. I think it was a long one. I really can't tell because I'm enjoying myself so much in this game. So what I'm going to do, I'll go ahead and leave off here. And I'm going to go ahead and mine. I'm going to fill up my inventory on both my ship and myself. Oh, myself is not gonna have to be able to take much more. Let's go ahead and move everything we can. Get this, that. Oh, okay. Let's see. Life support. We have nothing, so we're gonna have to find. Oh, we have plutonium right here. The center isn't where I would think the center is. But I guess it is. Life support, plutonium. Nice thing about plutonium is it just fills up the whole thing. So anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and mine 4 slots of emerald, and then I will talk to you next time. Actually, I can move plutonium over now too. but yeah, I hope you have a great day, a great night, and I will talk to you next time. Bye! This is Cipher Deck. Peace out.